August 15th at 14:30. We're starting at the first fall of Petite Rivière de la Baleine,
which is 10 kilometers inland.
Sediments on both sides of the river are marine clay, which has been greatly affected by landslide movement. And on top of the clay, you can see some sand also, which have been left over by the Tyrrell Sea. Here are about 100 feet above sea level. Sorry for the shaking, but it's a bit windy up here. Actually in a consequent valley that has been eroded throughout the year, and on both sides we have the basalt rock cliff. Yeah, the pilot is showing to me remnants of a crash that occurred in 1954, I think.
Here in the foreground, there is a nice example of mass movement that took place in the marine clay deposit, where in the background we can see former Tyrrell Sea shorelines. There are a series of parallel sandy ridges up to 2 meters high.
Stratigraphy up here started from bottom to top. Start with the Archean basement, and then some quartzite, dolomite, and it is capped by basalt. The basalt shows some nice columnar joints, and it is about 30 to 50 meter thick. So here's the the actual delta of Petite Rivière de la Baleine. It's mostly sandy material that is still redistributed nicely by the waves. Description. The basalt is gently dipping about 5 to 10 degrees towards the Belcher Islands, and it shows some really nice rocky shore. The whole area here has been under the Tyrrell Sea. So that's the main reason why the rock outcrops are so clean and washed out. Although, the Tyrrell Sea created some really nice boulder fields to be worked as beaches. Sea ice is very active and creates some puddles and all kinds of erosional features on the rock.
Puddles are what we call in French marmites. The majority of them have been formed before the glaciations. However, glaciers and coastal processes have reshaped them to some degree.
Their size vary from a meter up to 10, 20 meters of diameter. Inside them, well, some of them are empty. But also inside them we can see some Precambrian boulders that's filling. the altitude here at Rivière de la Baleine is about 1,300 feet above sea level. And it will decrease generally all the way down to Grand Rivière de la Baleine.
White you see along the shoreline is the surf zone. It gives an idea on a windy day like today of the power of breaking waves. This part of the shoreline is exposed to a longer fetch. This is the mouth of Kujiltuit River. Notice the shape of its delta, which represents a classic example of high waves energy environment. Most extensive sand beaches do occur where there is large river discharge, like we see here. As soon as we are moving away from the influence of the river, we are back into rocky shorelines.
one neat thing with basalts is there are some pseudo bedding planes in the basalt, and the basalt release blocks of 1 meter to 2 meters in diameter, and that's one reason that it's quite easy to create those puddles that I was talking about.
We are halfway between Kojotuit River and Second River.